Good morning, John. It's Hank. It's Tuesday, April 17th, and Lexington Catholic would like you to come to Kentucky.
All right. We love John Green!
Hi, John!
I'm Claire.
And I'm Abby.
And we're coming to you from Lexington, Kentucky!
Well, we're gonna tell you why we're making this video. This year, our sophomore class read Paper Towns by you, and we all loved it.
It's weird how much we've never read a book that everyone has liked so much.
A lot of people came up to me and were like, I don't ever read literature books, but I read this one and I liked it.
And it's inspired other kids to read other books you've written. It's just gotten our whole school into
a lot of people are looking for Alaska and the Fault in the Stars. I've read your books before and Nerdfighter and watched your videos on YouTube, and we just loved you.
Okay, so the reason I like Paper Towns so much is because after I read it, I sat in my bed and just thought to myself, it's weird how much I relate to this character. Margot is me, I feel like. Everyone in her city is just living life blindly and going to parties and not actually caring about anything. I felt like that for a long time about people that I know, and the fact that she wants to go to New York and the fact that she wants to get away, it's just how I've always felt.
We're talking about Paper Towns. And so I suggested Paper Towns to my lit teacher because I thought he would enjoy it. And he read it over Christmas break, and as soon as we got back to school, he came up to me and was like, I'm teaching Paper Towns to the sophomore class this year because it's amazing and it has to do with Walt Whitman. And I got really excited, and everyone else didn't really understand why I was excited until they read it, and then they got really excited because it's amazing. Peanut
Yeah, we're honoring your...
Be thankful, this is gross.
Peanut butter, multiple peanut butter...
Hi, my name is Taylor Stella, and I teach Honors American Literature at Lexington Catholic High School. This year, we read John Green's novel, Paper Towns, in class, in conjunction with her study of the poetry of Walt Whitman.
What were your initial thoughts when you were reading Paper Towns by John Green?
I knew right away that I needed to teach this book. Right away.
Why did you want to teach it so badly?
One, because it was well written. Two, I felt the subject matter related to students and they could identify with the characters. Three, it's the first book I've read that took poetry from the 19th century and was able to apply it to show relevance to 21st century kids. And
are you gonna teach it again?
Yes, definitely.
Have you ever read any other John Green books?
First John Green book I read was Looking for Alaska.
Found it.
And it was fantastic. I felt it was just as good. I couldn't teach it, I don't think, because it's a little racy at times.
This is Lexington Catholic High School's reaction to Paper Towns by John Green.
I have a bubble in my throat.
Why? What do you enjoy most about Paper Towns?
I thought that it was a refreshing book. It's not what you normally read. It was something different than normal.
First time all year, I think everybody in our class actually read the whole book and enjoyed it. They weren't forced to read it. Everyone just wanted to.
I really, really enjoyed it. I thought it was a good book, and it talked about so many different things that relate to being a high school student. And I just thought it was interesting, and it kept you wanting to read more, and very relatable, as I said before. And these are the things that I came up with, like, that relate to the theme and characters, and I tried to go semi-order in the storyline, so like over here, I thought that was like related to the beginning of the book, like the excitingness of, you know, like pulling an all-nighter with his best friend and Margot. And I really love this, contrary to popular belief, fitting in is out. And I think like that's an important lesson that you can take from the book. And it's just a bunch of stuff that I have collected and like thought wasn't.
I really enjoyed that. It was like relatable.
actually relate to, and I didn't. I knew what they were saying the whole time, and the characters were real.
It really relates to our lives. Uses like our kind of language and vernacular.
I enjoy that it can be really relatable. Out of all the books we read in my class, I related to it the most, and I feel like you can learn a lot from the message.
Relatable!
Who was your favorite character?
I had a crush on Margaret.
Which metaphor do you choose?
One of the very first things that really struck me about Paper Towns was when I read about the vessel, and when Margot was talking about how our vessel can crack, and then Q was saying we didn't really see each other until we saw through each other's cracks. And that's when I knew that I loved this book, because I hadn't been able to give a name to what I had felt previously, but Margot and Q were just like speaking to me. They named what I was feeling, and they gave me a way to like think about it. Well, I guess you did, because you wrote it.
The metaphor that really struck me was the strings, and partly the grass, partly the strings. I like the connectedness. Everyone is interconnected. Everyone has something that is connecting them to everyone else. But I also like how the strings are, you know, if one pops, if one string breaks, at any point, you can just fall apart. And all of us, the strings are kind of connected themselves. Inside of us, all our strings are connected, and they're all fragile, and we're all just trying to get by without breaking all of them and falling apart. Hugh needs to be the college boy with a plan.
Because I want to, like, go to college.
I would choose the strings because everyone has a certain point before they break. So you have only so many pieces that are held together by strings.
Strings, because like how it can all be like broken at one point.
It was
come to Lexington.
Dude, thank you very much for writing. You're a great writer, keep going. Keep doing it. I would love to meet you. Please come to school.
Can you come to Kentucky? To Lexington Catholic High School.
Thanks for the book. I enjoy your books immensely. Keep writing. Keep posting to your video blog. I think it's very funny.
Kentucky John Green, we love you. You come to Kentucky, please. DFTBA.
DFTBA!
DFTBA.
DFTBA.
Go.
DFTBA.
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 DFTBA. Just do the sign thing.
DFTBA. DFTBA.
DFTBA.
Okay, that's good.
DFTBA.
Just cut out the last
John, it is 1:50 in the morning. I've been working really hard on this video. As you can see, I've got my favorite friend here. And we just really want you to come to Lexington.
Please come to Lexington.
Because this... We just worked really hard, okay?
We want to meet you.
And, you know, it would just be awesome if you came.
Totally awesome.
So, this is not a joke. This is awesome. Funny.
Yeah.
So, who is that?
Selena.
Oh, I was like,
do I know you? So, we love peanut butter face. So we're putting peanut butter on our face. Peanut butter, peanut butter, peanut butter, peanut butter.
After I read it, I sat in my bed for like 2 hours and cried.
When you laugh, the spit comes
out. At least it's warm. It's like my face is wanting to sweat, and it won't come out.
Have you read any of the other John Green books?
Yeah, I read, what's that name?
DFTBA. You can if you want, but you don't have to.
We want you to come to Lexington.
Just cut that.
Because he talks about serious things with peanut butter, so we have to talk about serious things with peanut butter.
What metaphor would you choose out of all the ones in the book?
I'm gonna wash this off my face.
Please don't do that, guys.
Okay, what do you enjoy about Paper Towns?
You're so mature!
You have to... Oh, you didn't get a good lick, did you?
Oh my god.